My name's Alan Hart, and today I'm doing day in the life of a gas engineer. So I've been called out to a Baxi boiler. So it's been capped off as being unsafe. This boiler's about 2 years old. Apparently it was installed by a gas safe registered engineer. But I'm gonna have a look at all the paperwork. I'm gonna ring gas safe and just see what's going on here. So what I'll do now is we'll have a look and I'll show you the faults with this, and I'll show you the reasons why it's been capped off, and then from that I'll rectify some of the issues, and then we'll hopefully get it back up and running again. So let's have a look now, and I'll show you round the boiler. So this is a Baxi Duo-Tech boiler. In my opinion, this is one of the best boilers of all time. Really bulletproof boiler, and it just does what it says on the tin. So if we have a look underneath at this first, so we can just see it's been capped off there. And then if we have a look, first of all, the boiler is just there. So the boiler is just plugged in, so there's no spur on the boiler. And then if we have a look at everything else, all looks like it's all okay. And then if we go into this room here, so I'll just put light on in here, see if we can see a bit better. If we go into here, we can see it flew, goes through there. If we have a look, it's got part of the flue missing. So it's only got, I don't even know what that is. We'll take that off shortly, and we'll have a look at that. We'll just have a look outside. And then we'll look outside. We can see, I don't even know what type of flue that is, but we'll pull it out and then we'll have a look. So when we actually look inside this, it's actually that insulation board put in just to pop it up, just to sort of like hold it up. I'll take this off now and then we'll have a look a bit better. So there's no paperwork for this boiler as such, so there's no benchmark. So normally you'd have a benchmark booklet, and that'd have all the readings in of the emissions and all the bits and bats for when it were installed. So there's none of that here. These some paperwork. There's a gas safety certificate that's dated March 2018, and there's also something here to suggest that it was fitted on December 2016. I'm gonna ring gas safe up and I'm just gonna just double check about that. But yeah, so let's have a look at the boiler. I'll take this flue off, and yeah, let's go and have a look at it now. I'll cut this flue out now and we'll have a look. So we've obviously got an issue there with how the flue falls as well, because it's got water in the flue. So we'll have a look now. So I'll just pull this flue out. Actually looks like it is a flue. So that on there, that's just loose, is that? I don't know what type of flow that is. It's obviously some sort of plume kit, maybe a multi-plume kit. So when I'm looking at this, that looks like that is the normal flue, because that's got the weather ring in there. So if it drips water from outside, it runs off, and it's got the screws in there. Another thing to point out with this is the PRV pipe is there. So I'm just wondering if a builder's moved this. So I've just gone and got a new flue. And if you have a look on the new flue, it's got that ring there. And it's got the screw points there, the screw holes. So I'm wondering if a builder has taken the end off, this end off here, and then just put some sort of plume kit on the inside of there. I'm going to take flue off top up boiler now. I'm going to totally renew this flue, just so that I know that it's all correct. This part of the flue, as you can see from there, it's all cemented in. So this part's been done, installed well. Now if you compare it to that bit, it seems very different. My belief is a builder has extended this and not the original gas engineer, but I'm still going to check with Gas Safe, and we've still got no benchmark, but customer could have, the old customer could have taken that with them, because this is somebody new now that lives in this property. So this looks not too bad in here, really. They've made an effort at sealing it with sand and cement. So I'm just going to remove this elbow nail. Just one thing I have noticed there, the flue actually falls away from the boiler. So it falls down to what would be outside. So that's why it's had water in the flue. So the flue should always fall back to the boiler. So that took some getting out. So as I can see now, that's just the standard telescopic flue. And this were all cemented in really well. As I say, it's took some getting out. So I'm just going to put the new flue on now. These flues come with some silicone grease, and you just put some on them seals in there, just so that when you put it onto the boiler, you don't pull seals out. One thing to point out as well is this is a low profile elbow on these now, and they need to be screwed as well. The other one wasn't screwed. So I'm just gonna put this up boiler now. So we now need to check that the new flue is gonna fall back to the boiler. So about there, I'll just need to wedge that up. So I've done the flue part of this now. So I'm going to connect the gas back up, and then I'm going to test the gas. So just disconnect this cap under here. I've already slackened it off. And then I'm going to tighten that up, and I'm going to go put a test on gas. So I'm just going to put a test on gas now. So I've got my tighten test. I know we had some mixed feedback on that. So yeah, that's not great. And I've got the cane analyzer. I'm going to do it with cane because I'm going to print it out as well, just to prove that it's right. So I'll come back to you in a few minutes.
So as we know, we've got a 4-minute test. So we've just tested for let by. Now we're doing a minute stabilization, and then we've got 2 minutes for the test. So we've just got about 8 seconds left on this test now. And we can see there that it's not dropped at all. So I'm just going to print that out. And then I've just got some proof then of that.
I'm also going to gas rate this now. This boiler is a 40 kilowatt boiler and it's quite far away, it's all the way down the corridor. And the gas is 22 mil, so I do suspect that it will be undergassed. So I'm just going to go fire the boiler up and we'll have a look, we'll see. I'll just do a gas rate on it.
So I'll just take this sticker off, turn the boiler on. So to put this into commissioning mode or service mode, you just put it onto there, just turn it there and back, and it'll go into service mode. So that's service mode on high, and then you can turn it down to low. Just one thing, while you're doing this, if you run the hot tap, then it'll stay in service mode longer. I've got an app on my phone and I'm just going to put the reading in, so it's 103.438, and then we'll start that when it gets to 38. So start that now and then I'll just come back to you in a few minutes. So I've just turned gas off and it's at 545. So it's at 545, so we can calculate that now. And it's given us 34. So we can see it's definitely under gassed. I'm going to test this now with the analyzer, test the inlet pressure of the boiler. One thing to point out here, if you have a look at the pressure gauge, that was at 1 bar. Now this is a big heating system and it's only got the expansion vessel that's in the boiler, so clearly the expansion vessel is undersized for this system. So that's also something that I'm going to have to say to the customer to advise to update. So the emissions are fine on high and low. I'm just going to swap that now and check the air inlet and make sure that that's okay as well. So the air inlet is fine. So pressure gauge has gone all the way round to 3 now as the system has got warm. So it definitely needs an expansion vessel, an additional expansion vessel fitting.
I've just called Baxi and Baxi have confirmed that the boiler has not been registered. I've then phoned GasSafe and GasSafe also confirmed that the boiler hasn't been registered. So it seems like it wasn't installed by a GasSafe engineer. I don't know, the jury's out. I have got some information here which says certificate of installation, and it says that the boiler has been installed as per manufacturer's instructions and complies with building regulations, installed and commissioned, and it says a name and it's signed. So that a customer looking at that would feel that it's been done correctly. So what's going to happen next is this is going to be reported to GasSafe, and GasSafe can do some investigations and see. It's beyond me now. So I'll have a look. I'll show you the rest of what I've done here. I'll show you flue, and then we'll finish off really. So always make sure that that you use a gas safe registered engineer. And if you're going to buy a property, it's very easy just to phone Gas Safe up and just ask them if the boiler that's been installed has been registered. So don't rely on certificates that your solicitor gives you. Actually phone Gas Safe and then they will tell you whether or not it has. As I say, the customer's got a few different certificates here that would suggest that it's been installed and it's been installed correctly. It says it's been installed to manufacturer instructions and it hasn't. There's quite a few reasons it hasn't. So the gas is undersized, the blow off, the PRV doesn't go to outside, the flow was incorrect. Also, there's no controls on it. So it's just on and off on here. It hasn't even got a timer or anything to control it. So clearly it hasn't been a very, you know, a very good install. But we'll have a look at the rest of it now. We'll just have a look at flue. And yeah, that's all up now. So I'm just going to check the water flow on this just to see if it was the right size boiler for this property, because I would never install this boiler. So we've got about 10 litres a minute on hot water. And we've got about 10 litres a minute on cold water. So they could have had a 24 kilowatt or a 28 kilowatt and that would have done what they needed it to do. 40 kilowatt boiler and it's got 10 litres a minute on cold. This boiler would really, you need to have at least 18, 19 litres a minute on your cold water so the boiler will work to its full potential. This boiler is far, far too big for this property. You don't need a 40 kilowatt boiler for 10 litres a minute. It's just madness. The other thing as well, the gas wouldn't have needed to be so big if it had had right size boiler. So they could have fitted a 24 or a 28 kilowatt boiler in this property and it would have just done just as good. In fact, it'd have probably been slightly better. So yeah, it's just crazy really. Right, okay, so let's have a look at the rest of the stuff now. So that's the flue outside, all done now. So you can see the pressure has gone above 3 bar now. And if we have a look here, we can just see a bit of water there. And it's running down on the inside in the house. So I just need to wipe that flue off. So I've sealed it inside and outside. We just need a bit of filler. I'll just see if I've got some now. I've only had time to do the flue today. I'm going to make some recommendations for the customer. So the gas needs to be updated. It needs the blow off the PRV taken. That needs to be taken to outside. It needs a remote expansion vessel fitting as well. Also, it's got some radiator valves that are leaking. So they need replacing. So yeah, I hope I've not missed out. That I wanted to put in here. But if you've got any questions, please ask them in comments below. And thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Thanks very much.